You probably already know about the various shapes like a rectangle, square, triangle, parallelogram, etc. And also probably you already know about the formulas to calculate the areas too. But do you know why those formulas work? Do you know why the area of a rhombus is half into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2? And if you don't, this video series is exactly about that. This is part 1 of the video series that I'm talking about, and this tells you exactly how to derive the formula of the area of each two-dimensional shape. So come on, let's nail it. Now probably you are already aware about the area of a rectangle because we have been studying it from time immemorial that the area of a rectangle is nothing but the length times the breadth. Now the rectangle could be drawn on a piece of paper or it could also be a TV screen hanging on the wall. And if it's a TV screen, instead of calling it the length and the breadth, we can also call that maybe this side is called the base and this will be called the height. So you can say that the area of a rectangle is base times height. Now this is a formula that we are all familiar with and we have been doing it since the last so many years. And we are going to understand the areas of the other shapes with respect to the base times height. So as you see in a rectangle, it has a base and it goes up to the top and you see that the top portion is also the same as the bottom portion. And that is why it is base times the height. Now we are going to learn about the areas of all shapes with respect to the shape of a rectangle. So just remember this, that the area of a rectangle is nothing but base times the height. Now let's look at a figure like this, which is actually a square. And you know, in a square, all sides are equal. And we let's say this, all these sides are equal and let the side length be S. So if this is S, this is also S. And since the area of a rectangle is base times height, the area of a square, that being a similar shape like a rectangle, will also be base times height. So since the base and height both are S, it should be S times S or it should be S square. So let's write this also on the side, that the area of a square is nothing but the square of the side or S square. Now I keep doing a lot of similar things on my channel, and if you are a student of mathematics or want to learn certain concepts about mathematics, you should consider subscribing to the channel, and just do so by clicking the subscribe button at the bottom of the video, and also do not forget to click on the notification bell because that will make sure that you get each and every video to your email. Let's have a look at the next shape that we have and let's consider a triangle. Now the triangle also has a base and it has a height as well. So to find the height, we'll just drop a perpendicular from the vertex opposite the base. And if it is a perpendicular, it forms a 90 degree angle and let this height be h. But how do we find the area of the shape? As we see, the top portion of the triangle is not the same as the base. So obviously it can't be base times the height. But what if we convert this triangle into a rectangle? So let me draw a dotted rectangle around it to make the rectangle complete. So if this is the rectangle, now we see that the rectangle also has a height, which is h, and the area of the rectangle would be base times height. But we don't want to find the area of the rectangle, we want to find the area of the triangle. So to do that, let's name the sides of the triangle first. So let me call this A, B, C, and this point where the perpendicular meets, let that be D, and these two points, let those be F and G. Now we are looking at two triangles here. One is triangle ABD, which is this one. And the second is the triangle AFB, which is this one. Now if you look at these two triangles, you see that this side is the same as this side because it's a rectangle. Now even AFBD is also a rectangle. So since the opposite sides are equal, we can say that BD is equal to AF. And same way, these two sides are also equal, which means that FB will be equal to AD. And as you see that this is the common side, so we can say that AB is equal to AB. Now since all three sides of the triangle are equal to each other, we can say that by SSS congruency rule, triangle ABD, now let me name it carefully, so ABD will be congruent to triangle BAF. Now, if these two triangles are congruent, that means the area also should be equal. And similarly, these two triangles are also equal, so their areas will also be equal. Now, if we look at this rectangle AFBD, we don't want the full thing. We just want half of that. So we can exclude this. And since the areas are equal, we can say we are just looking at half of this complete area of the rectangle. And if we look at this rectangle here, again there are two congruent triangles which have equal areas, and we can exclude this part and we can say that the area of the portion that we want is just half of the rectangle here. So since we are excluding half of both the triangles of both the rectangles, we can just say that the area of a triangle is half times the base times height, which is the area of a rectangle. So let me write that also down here, that the area of a triangle is half times base times height. Now let's look at a parallelogram, a figure like this. This is a parallelogram. Parallelogram, as you know, that the opposite sides are parallel and equal to each other. So the parallelogram also has a base and it also has a height, which again we'll drop a perpendicular from the vertex opposite to the base. And let's call that height as h. Now this is not a rectangle, as you can see that this is slightly a crooked rectangle. So let me find the area of a rectangle first. Let me again draw a sort of a rectangle to complete it. And since the area of a rectangle is base times height, now we have got this height as h, but there's this little extra portion here that we don't know what it is, but let's call that as x. Now, since the both opposite sides are equal to each other in a parallelogram, then this also has to be x. So the area of the complete rectangle that we have will be the base times height. Base in this case is b plus x and the height is h. So if we simplify this, distribute h to both of them, we get base times height plus height times x. We get b into h plus x into h. Now we are excluding the area of these two triangles from this rectangle because we are looking at just the area of a parallelogram. So we know that the area of a triangle is half times base times height. So let me calculate the area of this triangle first. So the area of this triangle would be half times the base times the height. So half base would be x, and height, since the height is h, we can say that it is half x into h. Let that be triangle 1, and now we are looking at the other triangle, which is triangle 2. Here also it's half, the base again is x here and the height is h. So the total area that we are excluding is half x into h plus half x into h, which makes it full x into h. So we can say that the area of the parallelogram would then be the area of the rectangle, which is b into h plus x into h, and subtract the areas of the two triangles, which is again x into h. So the x into h and x into h cancels out, and we are just left with base into height. So again, the area of a parallelogram also is base times the height. Now we've got other shapes also, like a rhombus, a kite, a trapezium. How do we find the areas of those? So let's have a look at that also. And if you want to have a look, just click on this video appearing here. Do not forget to click on my photograph here to subscribe to the channel. And do not forget to smash the like button. And as far as the area of a rectangle, square, triangle and parallelogram is concerned, congratulations, you have nailed it. Take care. God bless. I'll see you on the other video.